Are you looking for a way to spice up your live streams? Well, maybe StreamAlive has a solution for you. In this video, I'm going to review it so I can let you know if it's something that you should grab or not. So let's go check it out. There are several things that I like about StreamAlive, but there's just one big downside that I dislike about it, and you'll hear about it later. Now, things that I like about it. First of all, it's a lifetime deal, so we're getting a great price for it, and we're just paying once for it. The second thing that I like about it is that it's really interactive, and I like how it actually flows. So let's talk about the lifetime deal that's going on right now. It starts off at $39 for the lifetime deal. So that means you pay once and use forever. Let me show you the limits really quickly. So it's based on license tier. And the first license tier is $39. The only thing that it doesn't have is custom branding. So if you're looking to remove the StreamAlive branding, you'll need license tier 2 or 3. And you'll need to check out the limits to see if they're enough for you. Why? Because, for example, there's 100 maximum Zoom live stream participants. So if you are streaming Zoom and you have more than 100, then you'll need to jump into license tier 2 or 3. But for most people, license tier 1 is more than enough, except for the removable branding, okay? Now, let's go jump over to StreamAlive. StreamAlive is available for 3 platforms: YouTube, Microsoft Teams, and Zoom. It's not available for other platforms as of this video. Now, be aware, and that's one of the big downsides about StreamAlive, it's that it doesn't actually stream, okay? You have to do your own Zoom meeting, and this is going to capture the chat from that meeting to display the interactions. Now, it sounds kind of tricky, but I'm going to show you how it works and how you're going to get started with StreamAlive. So, for example, I'm going to give you an example with Zoom, and this is what you have to do to get started with Zoom in case you want to use StreamAlive. So I'll add a meeting, and I'll name it, for example, testing for video, and I'm going to need the Zoom link. So let's go into Zoom. Let's create a brand new meeting. So like I said, this is the way that you would do it. Let me stretch this a bit. Participants, let's go into copy invite link. Let's add it here. You can set the date if you like. It doesn't really matter in this case. Let's go ahead and confirm. And we have it created here. I'm going to connect to this section. And now we're ready. But we need to accept it over here on Zoom. So in Zoom, we need to admit StreamAlive. So once we admit it, it's going to display here. So here it is, StreamAlive. Let me open up my camera. There we go. So this is how it's going to display. Like I said before, StreamAlive is not actually going to stream the interactions. So we need to use a workaround for this. So let's go ahead and share the screen. Oh, share screen. And I'm gonna set the specific tab for this one. Yeah, is it this? Yeah, share. Okay, so now we're actually sharing that particular live stream. So they would be able to view the interaction now. Now, what are these interactions that StreamAlive has? So let's go into create an interaction. Let's use, for example, Magic Map, which is one of my favorites for this. And let's enter the question, for example, where are you from? And we can only admit one answer, or we can leave it open. In this case, I'll leave it open for demo purposes. Show comments overlays if you like, and colors for this. So we can change the colors if we like. Let's start the interaction. So how does this work? Okay, in Zoom, where people are actually interacting, let me stop the share for this. Where people are interacting is where this is going to be displayed. So let's go ahead and open up the chat here. Let me make it smaller. So remember, this is happening in Zoom in your live stream, and this is the StreamAlive section. Remember, I stopped sharing the screen, but you would be able to display it in that sense. So if people say, if I ask on the live stream, hey, where are you from? And people start saying, you know what, I'm from Rome, I'm from Spain. You can see how displaying the chat bubble on the bottom, who's it typing, and it's displaying over here. Hong Kong, for example, and it'll grab cities also and states and all of that. For example, if I type Los Angeles, it'll actually grab it. So here it is, it's displaying there. If I, for example, say San Diego, it's gonna display it. It's really close, there we go, San Diego, and you can see who actually typed it. So if you're interacting in a live stream and people are actually viewing this, it makes them want to actually type where they're from, okay? Why? Because instead of just seeing a chat where it just gets lost, well, they're actually viewing here in their active map. And that's what makes live stream really interesting, because it spices up your live streams. Now, there's more things that we can do in StreamAlive. So for example, more interactions, I can do a power poll with options. So I can say, do you like this? Talking about StreamAlive. I can say yes or no. Let's go ahead and continue. Let's start the interaction. And again, we're in Zoom, we're asking people, do you like this? Type whatever you wanna ask, okay? And people could type, for example, 1, and it adds it, or they can type yes, Well, it's not going to add it because it's already 100%. But if I say no, it should add it. There we go. Now, so we have two yes and one no. So you can type one or you can type the word. Now, I've noticed that sometimes this is case sensitive. So if I type no with an O, did it grab it? No. So do be considering that. It is case sensitive. That's something that they should work because, I mean, in a simple question like this, yes or no, I mean, some people might put like the Y or the N in capital letter, especially if they're on their phone. So just something to consider there, StreamAlive. There's also more interactions. For example, there's a poll without options. So you can type in many options there and it'll display it there and it'll do it. It could be an open question, for example. Wonder words where you just type it in words and it's going to display it. So let's go ahead and start the interaction. For example, I can say happy. Is it gonna grab it? There we go, happy. Joy, mad, sad, etc. You get the idea, right? And it creates this cloud of words. Again, like I said, it's interaction for the live streams. There's also choice circles, transient thoughts, quick questions, etc. And you can use all of these for this purpose to spice up your streams. So you saw how it worked with Zoom, and it's super easy to get started. It works the same way with YouTube and with Microsoft Teams, and just like that. In YouTube, you need to connect it to your account. In this case, I've connected it to SaaS Master, and it'll detect the live stream to get started. So it works in a different way. It's not like you share a link and it grabs it from there like it does with Zoom. But just like that, you're able to start using StreamAlive in Zoom. Now, once you have these streams, you can also automate these questions beforehand. So you can create templates here with all of these. For example, I'll say test, and you can create interactions like these and have them ready for your live stream. Once you have them ready, you can use it on your templates over here. So if I start again, if I want to create a new meeting, actually the meetings that I have already, I can run the show, which is this right here. And I select what template I want to use from the ones that I've created previously. There's also the analytics for this, for each one of these sections. And it's pretty cool that we get these analytics. Even if you don't stream this, I mean, if you're just asking, for example, if you're just asking on Zoom and you're not displaying all of this, you're at least getting these stream results here. So you can later display them or have them for analytics. So for example, if you click on this, you get the answer for that particular person. If there's more people, we'll see them here. And it's these the analytics that help you out with these type of sections. And basically that is StreamAlive. I mean, it helps you spice up your live streams. Like I said, the downside that I see about it is that it won't stream directly. So we need to actually stream the screen. Workaround for this is actually streaming it from here, selecting like I just did. So share the screen with it here, or have another computer and stream it from there. So I don't know, you have more control for this, but that's how it works. And if you wanna grab it, like I said, there's a lifetime deal going on right now. The link is in the description. If you wanna help me out with a small commission, you buy through that link and it helps me out make these videos for you. And well, that's a wrap for live stream.